Give the denary number of each of the three 12-bit binary values. The first thing to notice about this binary number is that we have 8 zeros preceding the first one. Whenever we have a binary number that has lots of preceding zeros, we can actually just remove these zeros. And this is going to speed up our calculation, as we only need to work out a 4-bit binary number as opposed to a 12-bit binary number. Let's go ahead and write our remaining bits down. Starting on the least significant bit, which is our far right bit, we're going to write down its denary equivalent for that bit position. So the easiest way to remember this is by writing down the number 1 and continuously multiplying that by 2 as we move left. So 1 multiplied by 2 gives us 2. Multiply that by 2 and we get 4. Multiply that by 2 and we get 8. Now all we do is wherever we have a 1, we're going to circle the number beneath. Whenever we have a 0, we're going to cross that number out. So starting on the far left, we have a 1. So let's go ahead and circle the 8. The next number is a 1. So we're going to circle the 4. We then have a 0. So we cancel out the 2. And we've got a 0. So we're going to cancel out the 1. Now all we do is add the numbers that we've circled, which is going to be 8 plus 4. This gives us 12. So 12 is the answer. The next number we have, we can do the same thing as we did with the first number, and that is to cancel out as many preceding zeros as we can until we reach a 1. Let's go ahead and start at the least significant bits, and we'll write down a 1, multiply that by 2, 4, 8. We now again want to multiply this by 2, essentially until we get to the end. So 16. 16 times 2 is 32. 32 times 2 is 64. 64 times 2 is 128. All right, starting at the left, we're going to circle the numbers that have a 1 and cancel out those numbers that have a 0. So first number, we have a 1. We're going to circle the 128. Second number, let's circle the 64. Third, we're going to cancel the 32. Fourth, cancel the 16. Cancel the 8, circle the 4, circle the 2, and cancel the 1. And we're left with the sum, 128 plus 64 plus 4 plus 2, which gives us 198. Let's go ahead and write that value in, and we'll do the last number. Again, we can remove this initial 0, as that doesn't add anything to the number. And again, we'll write down the denary equivalents for each of these binary bits, starting with the least significant bits. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Now 128 times 2. I have to do a bit of mental math for this. 256. Multiply that by 2, we get 512. And then we have 1024. Unfortunately, you can't take a calculator into the exam, so just make sure you can multiply by 2. All right, starting on the far left, let's circle the numbers that have a 1, cancel the numbers that have a 0. So we'll circle 1024, cancel 512, cancel 256, circle 128, circle 64, cancel 32, cancel all of these numbers, and we'll circle the 1. All right, and this is the part where most people make mistakes, which is making sure that you get the math correct. So just double check that you've got this calculation correct. And that result is going to give us 1,217. Let's write this number over here. And that is this first part complete. Part B, we have 12-bit binary values can also be represented as hexadecimal values. Give the hexadecimal value of the 12-bit binary value. All right, so we've got this binary value over here. To convert a binary number into hexadecimal, we're going to start at the least significant bits and count 4 places to the left. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's keep track of this number over here. Let's do this again. So we're going to jump 4 places, 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's write down this number that we get, 1, 1, 1, 0. And lastly, we're going to jump 4 more places, 1, 2, 3, 4, that gives us 0, 0, 0, 0. The reason why we split up our binary number into 4-bit sections is because a single hexadecimal digit is equal to 4 binary bits, as I've written over here. The word for this is a nibble. So we're going to work out each individual nibble and find out the hexadecimal value for that nibble. The method we use is the same method we use to work out our denary number. So we're going to write down the denary equivalents starting from 1, 2, 4, and 8. We'll circle the number where there is a 1 and cross out the number where there is a 0. Let's circle 8, cross out 4, cross out 2, and circle the 1. And again, we apply the same formula, which is to add up the circled numbers. So we're left with 8 plus 1, which is going to give us 9. 9 is already a hexadecimal number, as the first 10 digits of hexadecimal are just the first 10 digits of denary. The second number we have, let's apply the same method. So write down the bit positions in denary, and let's go through this. We're going to circle 8, circle 4, circle 2, and cancel 1, and let's add these up together. Here we get 14. 14 is not a hexadecimal value. We need to convert this into hexadecimal. As we said earlier, the first 10 digits of hexadecimal are denary. The digits we get after that is going to be A, B, C, D, E, and F. These digits are equivalent to the denary numbers 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So this number 14 is equivalent to E. The final number, we have 0, 0, 0, 0. We don't even have to write down the numbers. We know that this is just going to be equivalent to 0. So to get our answer, we're going to put these hexadecimal numbers one after the other in the right order. The first number that came up was 0, 0, 0, 0. So we're going to write our 0 first. We then had 1, 1, 1, 0. So we're going to write down E. And then we had 1, 0, 0, 1. So we're going to write down 9. And there we have our answer.